All right, hey, I was at a dollar store today and I come across this limited edition Dreamworld Coca Cola. There's two kinds. This one is the zero sugar, the other one had 55 of sugar in it. 55 grams of sugar in the other one. This one has zero. All right, Dream World. I don't know what flavor this is, but let's have a taste. Let's open this up. Okay guys, let's give this a taste test. Dream World. Now you can see on here, this one here, the word Coca-Cola is in black. On the sugar one, it's in white. Dream World, it doesn't even say a flavor. Ooh, now that is different. Wow, now that's different. Aspartame. There's no sugar. Okay. Carbonated water, caramel color, natural flavor. What the heck's a natural flavor in it? Phosphoric acid, potassium benzonate, aspartame, a couple I can't pronounce, potassium citrate. Caffeine, a whole bunch of stuff that's not good for you. Just about everything. It doesn't really say what kind of flavor it is, and I can't really say. If the caramel means anything, caramel flavor, it's like a car. Yeah, it is like a caramel kind of a flavor. Doesn't taste like Coca-Cola at all. Like the original Coke. Sorry. That's it, the Coca-Cola Dreamworld sugar-free one. I wouldn't want to try the sugared one, holy. For me, wow. It's got everything in here that'll make kidney stones also. Whoa, and I've had one kidney stone once. This is it, guys. Try it out. I got it from the dollar store. Imagine you can buy it anywhere you can buy Coke. All right, guys, tonight's supper could be tomorrow's breakfast. What we're having is these freeze-dried hash browns I found at Costco. You can probably find them anywhere. They're called Golden Grill Hash Brown Potatoes. They're real potatoes. They're hash browns. You can see by my hand size how big the box is. And you would fill it, you fill the hot water to this line right here. There's a black line. So you fill hot water, you leave it for 12 minutes, and this thing makes supposedly, I think they said like 6 or 7 servings out of one box. There's only, this is a half a box. I've used the first half. There's only probably this much hash browns actually in there. It, man, makes quite a lot. So we'll do these. We'll boil up some water and then let them sit for 12 minutes. Then we've got a couple of eggs scrambled. We're going to scramble the eggs. We've got some farmer's type sausage here. We're going to take the skin off and just crumble it up and put that in. We've got some veggies, some carrots, onion, celery, a little bit of that. You could put mushrooms in if you like, shredded cheese, whatever you like. So first of all, let's get some hot water going and fill this to half. Wait, I think I've got a mark on here somewhere where I want to fill the water to. Yeah, I've got a little mark right here because I've done half. So, all right, what I'm going to do is take the skin off of these and just use, or just crumble up the inside so I can put it in my wrap or whatever you can. I'll take the skin off and crumble this up. There we go. And that's almost enough for one right there. Let's cut that in half. Okay. This is some good farmer sausage, man. Garlic. Wow. Is it ever good? Okay, those are ready. The potatoes are ready. All I have to do is scramble up a couple of eggs. We'll get a bowl ready for that. We've got the water boiling. All right, let's get our eggs ready for putting in there. A pinch of salt. All right, let's do our potatoes. We've got our potatoes ready. And that's a lot of servings, actually. Let's fill her up to here. Right up to that mark there. Yeah. Right there. Close it up. Leave that for 12 minutes. It's 25-2. At 13 minutes two, it'll be 12 minutes. And let's get our vegetables ready. Got enough vegetables in there for two. But let's start this. Get the vegetables going. And then the hash browns will come next. Actually, I should brown up the meat a little bit too while we're waiting here. Crumble that up and put that in. Beautiful. And then this last one, we'll divide this into two here. Then when this is done, we'll take it out grab the frying pan and add our hash browns. And then when the hash browns get 95% done, we'll put the egg in and then we'll top it up with this. Okay, I don't think I'm going to add any salt to this at all. I might put some other seasonings in here, whatever you like. All depends what kind of meat you put in here. Put like slices of sausage instead of crumbled up sausage, or hamburger, whatever you like in your hash brown omelet. That's what we're kind of making today, hash brown omelets. Okay, let's get this all incorporated a little bit here. Oops. Piece of celery tried to get away there. Okay. Okay, how are the veggies and the meat coming? The sausage. Looking good. I didn't put any mushrooms in. I am not too keen on mushrooms, but you could put those in. And I don't have any cheese. I'm not supposed to eat cheese anyways as a diabetic. I don't know if you're diabetic. You should know that you shouldn't be eating cheese. Oops. Okay. Another 2 more minutes and the hash browns will be ready. And we can take this off and put this in the other bowl. Okay, I'll come back at you when we're getting ready here. All right, it's been 12 minutes, guys. Let's open it up and see what we've got. Everything's all, wow. Okay, into the frying pan. Now I'm gonna turn the frying pan back on. I'll spread it nice and thin over the bottom. Now what you're looking for here is when it starts to turn golden brown on the edges. Then and only then are you ready. So we'll leave it like this. There's probably a lot of moisture in there yet. So we will let that go. Now, I have seen these potatoes called Idaho Spuds on, for the U.S. somewhere. You can probably find these all over there. They're freeze-dried, I would suspect. Very well to keep. It would probably last forever because they're freeze-dried. Light, can carry them around. Let me just see here. Now I think I had a box of 12 for $10. So that's less than a buck for these. And somewhere I thought it said, yeah, if you want it, if you want them to be a little bit more moist, you would leave them in the water for 15 minutes. These are good though. They're real potatoes, too, by the way. They're not your fake potatoes. If anything I hate worse is fake potatoes. Or if there's anything I hate more than That is fake potatoes. So we're starting to turn a little bit brown on there, so let's mix this up and flip. They're getting nice and golden brown on the bottom. Right on. So, like I said, when it's 95% done, then we'll put our egg on. And then by the time the other 5% of the potatoes are done, the egg will be done. So, let's spread this out nicely again. And this is going to make two omelets. Okay. Let's turn the heat down to medium. So, okay. Now, let's put our egg in. Having breakfast for supper. Now this has already got salt in it, so I won't put any more in. We'll leave it till the egg gets close. Now it's going to cook through there, and then once I flip it, the egg will cook all the way through. And then we'll divide it in half, and that will be one, two omelets. So we'll let that cook for just a second here. Vegetables and our meat ready. That's already cooked up. And it doesn't matter if the eggs are not quite done on here on top, because once you flip them, it will finish cooking. All right, I think we can put our vegetables and sausage on top. Spread that out. Like so. Actually, this pan stays quite hot for quite a while. Could probably turn the fire right off. Let's turn this back over this way a little bit better. Okay. Now, I'm just going to have a look. Bottom. I think it's coming along really well. And like I said, we'll divide it in half. Take this off and flip it over. And I need a bigger flipper. And now let's turn the fire right off. So I can plate this up for you and show you just what this looks like. Don't need that on anymore. Okay, like I said, look at the size. Look at the size of this one omelet. That's definitely almost for two people right there. Now, let's see if I can get this out of here nicely. Or the best I can. All right, so this is it. Your hash brown omelet with veggies and sausage.